Hey everybody. So as literally everybody in the world knows, coronavirus is going around right now and it's literally a giant, massive issue. And as a lot of you know, I'm currently in Spain, which is not a great place to be during this whole thing. I'm just gonna kind of talk about what it's been like being here, what my plan is for getting out of here. Yeah, so here are just some updates. So basically, I knew coronavirus was a thing. Like, for the past couple of months, weeks, people have been talking about coronavirus, but it was just one of those things, like, wasn't really affecting me. It was only in certain countries. Like, I feel like a lot of us didn't really take it seriously. Like, yeah, okay, it's in other countries, it's affecting other people, but we're all fine. The first time I really realized it was something serious was I was on my flight from Germany to Madrid after being in Switzerland for a weekend. And literally everybody on my flight was wearing face masks. And it felt like I was in a movie, felt like another world. And that was the first time that it kind of hit me, like, this is actually a serious issue. A couple weeks after that, so I was supposed to be studying abroad in Argentina for 6 weeks, and then Spain for 6 weeks, and then Italy for 6 weeks. And about 2 weeks ago, my Italy program got canceled because of how intense the coronavirus in Italy is. And so that sucked, but I was just like, okay, it's fine. I'll just stay in Spain for the rest of that block. So I'll be in Spain for 12 weeks total. It'll be fine, all's well. Then about a week ago, my Spain classes got moved online. And I was still like, okay, that's fine. Classes online, perfect. That means I can travel because I can do classes whenever I have Wi-Fi. So I booked trips to Copenhagen, Amsterdam, Barcelona, Morocco, all over the place. It really didn't dawn on me that things were getting really, really bad until the moment that me and some of my friends were in line outside of a club on Wednesday night, 2 days ago, today is Friday. And we were just sitting outside the club. Life is normal, it's 2 a.m. Big group of study abroad kids, all from America. And suddenly it was like an Amber Alert because everybody's phone started ringing, started getting texts, emails from everybody they knew. And what it was Trump had just announced that starting on Friday for 30 days, there was gonna be a travel ban on all people from Europe. So we're all Americans and we hear that after Friday, for 30 days, we can't return home to the US. So everybody's panicking. Parents are calling them, friends are texting them. People are sitting in line for the club, like we were all just ready to go out. And people are buying flights right there.
I could fly Chicago.
Flights went up so expensive. I know people who bought flights for $5,000. Like, legitimately, it was insane. But even at this point, like, I was still like, well, I was planning on staying here for 2 months anyways. I'll just stay in Spain for the 30-day travel ban, and I'll go home after. I'll just keep up with life as normal. I'll go on the trips I had booked. Like, I can stay within Europe, everything is good. Like, yeah, there's this virus going on and I can't go back to the US, but I wasn't planning on going back to the US. So like, it was fine, everything was fine. Parents left Friday morning, and Friday during the day, I get an email that Spain is in a state of emergency, which means that starting at midnight Friday, so last night, midnight, all restaurants, bars, stores, anything that's considered non-essential, so everything except grocery stores and pharmacies, is closed. Completely, doors shut down in the city. And the email also said that they didn't know about how long the airport would be open either. So this is when I'm like, I have to get my butt home. Like, even if I was planning on staying in Spain, everything's closed. I need to get out. So right then I buy a flight from Madrid to Amsterdam and then Amsterdam to Detroit, where I have screening, I believe, and then Detroit to Wisconsin, where I have to serve a 14-day quarantine. So yeah, I have a flight out, which is good. So as long as the airport doesn't close before then, we're good. But then literally last night, I get another email from my alert traveler thing that I get emails from that says, severe weather warning, flooding in Spain. So the airports might be closing because of freaking floods. I just feel like I'm in a movie. I feel like I'm in a simulation, like 2020. First there's worldwide plague. Second there's floods. Like, what's next? War, tornadoes, fires? I have no idea at this point, honestly. And it literally feels so fake, but also like now it's finally feeling real. And it's really, really interesting because stories like this I've seen on the news, like obviously not to this extent, but like things like this you've seen on the news before, the Ebola, the SARS, the MERS, like you see it on the news, But it's so weird living here and looking out my window and seeing it change day to day, hour to hour, like watching it with my own two eyes. On Thursday, after the news broke that Americans couldn't go back to the US, there were some stores that started to be closed. Like we were walking around, there was less people on the streets. Just felt a little eerie, like a little off. And then yesterday I was walking around and very few restaurants were open. Very few stores were open. Nobody really on the streets. Like the main public areas are usually packed. Plaza del Sol, Plaza Mayor, all empty, Subway's empty. And then last night we tried to go out to eat because all the restaurants were governmentally required to close at midnight. So we're like, okay, we'll go out to eat. And literally we called 20 restaurants. Only one restaurant we could find anywhere in the city that was open. So we go there, get our last dinner. But literally now, like, everything is closed down. It's a ghost town. There's nobody outside, nobody in any of the store windows. And it feels so eerie. It feels like I'm in an apocalypse movie, like one of those movies, Contagion, end of the world, whatever. And the beginning of the movie, everybody's like, oh, it's fine, everything's fine. Like, we'll be all right, it's no big deal. Then suddenly shit hits the fan. And it's a big deal. At this point, it's really, really hard to make any plans because I think I'm on like plan F right now. Plan right now is just getting on that flight, getting home to the United States. Tomorrow I fly out today. There's nothing really to do, but my friend Kaylee and I, we bought some ingredients for a picnic in the park, Retiro. So we're gonna go do that. And then I'm gonna have dinner in my friend's apartment a little bit later and then pack up my things and get ready to go and hope that everything goes smoothly tomorrow. You know when you're in a high school after hours and there's nobody there and you feel like you're in an alternate universe? That's what this whole city feels like right now. One thing that's really interesting for me is this is the first time in my life that I feel like I'm living history. Like, people say that when 9/11 happened, they remember that for the rest of their lives. Like, it's a story to tell, like, they were living a news story, whatever. And I was one when 9/11 happened, so I don't really remember that. But this is one of those things that, like, I can feel my kids reading about this in history books, and I'll be like, yeah, I was there in Spain when all this happened.
Update, the police are kicking us out of Retiro, so our picnic is kind of a bust. We just chatted with the cop. So apparently they're closing down Retiro right now and starting Monday and Tuesday, nobody can be in the streets. You have to stay in your houses.
Yeah,
yeah. You can't leave your houses.
We can like go to the airport, like maybe just get in a car and go to the airport.
I think so. We moved our picnic to Temple of Data Bode because it's still open, is what the cop said, for now. Girls become lovers who turn into mothers. So mothers be good to your daughters too. Okay, we're nervous because cops are coming. Oh, if we have to leave this park, it's gonna be a real bummer. So the police just came over just to warn us that we can't sit too close to each other. So we don't have to leave this park, but we have to sit distanced. So I can't touch. We're good. Since the day she saw him walking away, now she's left. Cleaning up the mess. Okay, so I feel like people really aren't taking this thing seriously in the United States. Overnight here in Spain, cases doubled. And things are changing so fast. So I recorded the first part of this video about 4 hours ago, and now, even since that, these 4 hours, things have changed drastically. So basically, to recap what happened to the park and everything, at Retiro, where we were at, cops came in, approached us, and told us they were closing down that park, which is the main park in Madrid. So we moved to a different park to do our picnic, and cops approached us there. And they told us we had to sit 6 feet apart, and the cops also told us that starting Monday, the entire city is on lockdown, and that means that nobody can leave their homes other than to go grocery shopping or to the pharmacy or hospital. So legitimately no one is allowed to be in the streets, no one's allowed to go for walks or runs, like you have to be in your house unless you're grocery shopping. Uber driver also told us that starting Monday, he doesn't think Ubers are going to be open. I have some friends who are supposed to fly out of here Monday or Tuesday. And their plan is to go to the airport on Sunday and just camp out in the airport until their flight is, because literally there's no other option. Like,
it changes so fast and things are getting so bad so fast. It's absolutely insane. So we're just sitting in the apartment and suddenly everyone in the streets and their houses is clapping and cheering, and we don't know why.
Out,
what's going on, Jacob?
I have no clue.
Hi, I know I look sickly right now. Promise I feel great. It is about 5:30 in the morning and I just got out of the shower. My flight is at 11, but I'm planning on leaving for the airport at 6:30, so I get there by about 7, so I have about 4 hours. I need to put some finishing touches on my packing. I have my bag wrapped up. Hopefully that does the job. Literally, like, it's an open suitcase just wrapped up, and it's like wide open because it's packed. If that bus opened on the flight, that would be really not ideal. I was just in line for Delta, but apparently my first flight is operated by a different airline. I need to be in a different terminal. Thankfully, I got to the airport 4 hours early. A long line ahead of me. In the right place now, I believe. It took a minute, but I made it through check-in. Girl's on her way to Amsterdam. There's nobody in security, which is beautiful. Boarding flight to Amsterdam. Hey, so made it to Amsterdam. It's not the tulip festival like I planned, but the airport's cute and there's lots of greenery. Have about 2 hour layover here and then flight to Detroit. And our I found some more study abroad kids. We're all stranded in Amsterdam trying to get back home. Flight to Detroit, bonding over the fact that we're getting evacuated. On the flight, boarded, on the way to the United States, which is lovely. Update, I definitely got out of Spain at the right time because today, if you're caught on the street outside, it's €150 fine, which is insane. So I land in Detroit in about 25 minutes. They gave us these health forms that we had to fill out. They said before we deplane, the CDC is going to come on the flight, give us some announcements, do our screenings. I don't know what that's all going to entail. I can see American soil. Okay, so they took us off the flight. We're going and meeting with the CDC people right now to get screened before we can go through, get our bags through customs, everything else. Customs. Just got an announcement. We now have additional screening, so that's cool. Just made it through screening and I have to go recheck my bags and get them through customs. I wasn't allowed to take my phone out during the screening, but I'll talk about it more in a little bit. So that last video I just took, I thought I was out of the screening area, so I thought I'd be fine to take a video. A man came up and asked to watch the video. He had a dog, because he wanted to make sure that I didn't show anything in the video that I couldn't. But basically, so went through a line. All the employees were very nice. They had like face mask shields on. We went in line, we had to fill out this form. They took our temperature, asked us where we all been, that kind of stuff. And they gave me a quarantine diary. So each day of quarantine, I have to record my temperature every morning and night and symptoms and whatever. But all went pretty smoothly.
I will fight for you.